the fact that you get to travel as well as do science was just like a winning combination for me.
Getting an all-expenses-paid trip to do science and have fun, I mean, you shouldn't have to sell it, right?
Greenland was, I think, something of an eye-opener for all of us. It really, you know, this is a remote research station. There's no Wi-Fi. I think it was a very impactful experience to have students that, you know, maybe are just used to life in the U.S. be put into an environment where you really have to think about what you're doing. You have to be careful. You have to use your own resources.
I feel very fortunate that I got to do this. I feel like I'd never meet someone else that was able to go to this part of Greenland or go to this unique place that we went to.
Greenland is, in some ways, the epicenter of climate change. Things are changing there so much more rapidly than anyone ever expected.
It might be the best place to capture climate change because of the importance of the freeze-thaw and how narrow the window is for life to exist. That's essentially why Zackenberg Research Station exists, is to see with the highest probability an area that is going to be affected by climate change. So being able to go there and see what all the other researchers are doing and to also add our research to the efforts is pretty cool.
There's a lot more to it when you're actually in the field and doing it, and it, when what the research you're doing matters. So you get a little more confident explaining what you do, why you do it, and how you do it.
And there they go.
This park has the last remaining remnant heard from before the Ice Age of muskox. There are muskox in other places around the Arctic, but they all come from that herd. So we had the opportunity to study muskox in their natural environment. And there's very little known about them. And I'm a microbiologist, so of course we were picking up fecal samples to study the microbiology of their intestinal tract with the hopes of learning more about how their digestive system works. It's really kind of a black box and a great opportunity, I think, for both the undergraduates and the graduate student.
It let me travel to a place I'd never been before and study a species that is almost impossible to study in the States. And as a wildlife biologist, that was really intriguing to me.
It's a very unique experience to actually be able to go to this part of Greenland. And I think that was my favorite part, being at that station where no one else can really experience that.
Everyone there is, you know, an entomologist, an ecologist. They're all very, like, developed scientists.
It was incredible. Zackenberg, the people there probably were the highlight of the trip for me.
Anyone in any field of science would benefit from this experience because it's not that easy to get lab experience. It's not that easy to get that one up on the rest of the students, and having that experience really will teach you a lot about yourself, but also teach you about what you want to do in the future.
When you stay in the U.S., you don't get that global perspective of all the potential that you have as a scientist to go and explore and work with other people who are all like-minded.
You truly are embedded in an international team doing research with international mentors. And that's really the primary goal of my program.
It's probably the coolest job. There's like professional sports and then being a scientist.